Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install MongoDB version 6 on a Windows operating system. And then I'm also going to show you how you can easily create collection and how to insert data. So you know, I am going to show you all of that on this video. So do watch the video till the end. If you like the video, then please give it a like and also please do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. So let's dive in into our video. So, to install MongoDB, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the search bar, just simply search with MongoDB download. And you'll get this, you know, MongoDB server as our first result. So, just simply open that link. I'm going to put this link in the description so that you can easily, you know, navigate to the download page. So here you need to scroll down and you need to click on this download in order to download version 6.03 for Windows. If you are using some other operating system, then you need to choose, you know, from here and you can easily download. Okay, I have already downloaded it. I'll just simply cancel it. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that our MongoDB is rightly downloaded over here. So in order to install, you need to just simply double click on the, you know, installer. And you can minimize our download directory and here you can just simply click on next. You can accept this license agreement, okay, and then just simply click on next. And here it is asking that whether you'd like to, you know, go for complete installation or custom installation. I'll recommend you to, you know, go for complete installation because, you know, it included MongoDB Compass in the complete installation. So I'm going to show you that in the next step. Before that, let's come to this, you know, service configuration. So here you can see that install MongoDB as a service. So it will, you know, going to install this MongoD, you know, in our service. So if you go to, you know, list of service, you can see this, you know, MongoD in your service. Okay, so the service name they have given is MongoDB, which is totally fine. Okay, and here is the, you know, data directory that they're going to create. So all our data is going to be reside over here. And they're also going to create the log file. So everything, every operation that you are doing, going to log over here. Okay, so everything is fine. I just wanted to explain you about MongoDB, the service name. So if you go to the list of service, you will get this MongoDB. Okay, so click on next. And this is what I was talking about. So this, you know, install MongoDB Compass. MongoDB Compass basically means, you know, a GUI interface it will give you. So GUI means graphic user interface. I'm going to show you that in the latter part of the video. So on that, you know, graphic user interface, you can create, you know, collection, you can insert data and you can do pretty much everything, whatever MongoDB actually, you know, gives you. Okay, so install MongoDB Compass, click on next, ready to be installed. Just simply click on install and, you know, it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And there you go. Our installation has rightly begun. So, you know, let's wait for a couple of minutes. Actually, the MongoDB Compass installation will take some time. Some, you know, about 5 minutes, I would say. So, let's wait for some time and then I'll be coming back. Yep. So, we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our MongoDB server is rightly installed along with our MongoDB Compass. So, you can just simply click on finish. So welcome to Compass. So let's click on start and there you go. Our MongoDB Compass is rightly launched. So let's maximize it. So this is our interface. So you can see that we have this port number called 27017. Okay, remember this port number, that's very important. Okay, you'll need it in future for sure. Okay, so let's connect it. And you can see that it is rightly connected. So if you, you know, click on database, it will going to show you whatever all database that are pre-installed. Okay, so we have a admin, config and local. So let's see how to create a database. So easy, very easy. Just simply click on create database and give a database name. So let's give the database name as practice DB. Okay, and you need to give the collection name. So let's give the collection name as software, you know, engineers. And just simply click on create database and there you go. Our practice DB is rightly created and inside our practice database we have software engineers. Okay, so now I'll show you how we can easily, you know, insert data. So let's say you have a file which contains data. You can easily do that by, you know, just clicking on this import file, and you can easily import a JSON or a CSV file. Okay, so you can easily, you know, click on a select file, and all your data that contains that JSON or a CSV file going to be import automatically. Okay, and here I'm going to show you how you can manually insert data. So for that, you need to just simply click on insert document. So, you know, here you can insert document. You need to just simply click on this hamburger icon, and you need to just simply click on plus, add a field after ID. So here you can, you know, give the ID like employee ID, EMP ID. Okay, and just simply hit tab, and you can give the ID called, let's say, 12. Okay, and you can again click on this plus icon, add a field after EMP, and give, you know, name field, let's say. And let's give the name as, you know, Rohit. So if you just simply click on insert, it's going to insert the data. You can see it rightly inserted. Okay, the object ID is unique, and then we have a, you know, employee ID which is 12, and the name field as Rohit. If you want to, you know, similarly insert one more data, you can do that by just simply, you know, clicking on this insert document again. And let's say you want to modify this. Let's say if you want, you can easily click on this, you know, pencil icon. And let's say you want to change the, you know, employee ID to 11, let's say. So just simply do that. It will show you document modified. So here you need to just simply click on update, and it will going to update. Document updated. If you want to delete, just, you know, simply click on this delete button. If you want to simply, you know, duplicate this data, just simply click on this. Automatically show you. Click on insert, and it's going to duplicate it. But if you see carefully, like this object ID, which is, you know, unique, is different. Okay, so every time, you know, you insert any new data, it's going to be different. So if you want to edit, you can do that by just again click on pencil icon, and you can change with, you know, Gautam, let's say, and update, and there you go, it's updated. If you want to delete, you can just simply click on delete icon, delete, and it will going to be deleted. Okay, so in this you can easily, you know, insert the data. And let's go back to our practice DB, and let's say you have a software engineers, you know, as our you know, collection. Let's say you want to create one more collection, so just simply click on create collection, and you can give a collection name called employee, let's say, create collection, and there you go, our collection is created. Go inside collection, you can similarly, you know, create your data. Okay, so that's basically all about this video. I have rightly shown you how to install MongoDB Compass, and I have also shown you how to use, you know, MongoDB. So that's basically all about this video. Please do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching, and God bless you all.